Hello friends and welcome to Explore Bio. In today's scenario, when the world is struggling and fighting against the novel coronavirus, every one of you must be aware of RT-PCR tests. RT-PCR, or the real-time polymerase chain reaction, is the most reliable test for the detection of COVID-19 infection till date. If you are a college student or a researcher, you should definitely not miss this video, because in today's video, I have tried to cover as much as information regarding RT-PCR based on the resources and my personal experience. In this video, you will learn what an RT-PCR is, how it is different from the conventional PCR, two of the most popular types of RT-PCRs, that is the intercalating dye-based and probe-based, and their working principles. What are the requirements of performing RT-PCR tests? Taking an example of COVID-19, how the probes and the primers are designed, how the RT-PCR test actually works, interpretation of the RT-PCR results, and at last some of the major advantages and applications of RT-PCR. So let's begin with what RT-PCR is. RT-PCR is a short for real-time polymerase chain reaction. It is a PCR variant in which one can detect and quantify the expression of a target gene based on the fluorescence produced upon template amplification. In RT-PCR, the mRNA acts as the initial template which gets reverse transcribed to cDNA. This cDNA undergoes several rounds of PCR amplification, which leads to increase in the fluorescence signal detected by the machine. Some confuses RT-PCR with the reverse transcriptase PCR because it involves reverse transcription of mRNA to cDNA in its initial steps. Now let's see how RT-PCR is different from a normal or a conventional PCR. In conventional PCR, you can amplify a gene or DNA locus which is later detected on a gross gel or a page. Now it has two major problems. One, that with the conventional PCR, precise quantification of gene expression is not possible. And secondly, the DNA template required is significantly more, as ETBR is less sensitive than the fluorescence dye. Real-time PCR, on the other hand, precisely detects and quantifies the expression of target gene in real-time manner after each PCR cycle. As it is fluorescence based, it is more sensitive in detecting minor differences in the gene expression. The machine that performs real-time PCR is equipped with the fluorescence detection and quantification systems. Fluorescence based detections makes it 1000 times more sensitive than conventional PCR. Also, the template that is required is in few picograms. Based on the chemistry used, two major types of RT-PCR exist. The first one is the intercalating fluorescent dye based. In this chemistry, as the cDNA gets amplified in consecutive PCR cycles, more and more double-stranded DNA products become available for the intercalating dye like cyber green, shown here with the green star, to bind and show fluorescence. Once the sufficient fluorescence is produced, it is detected by the instrument and reflects the expression of target gene. This type of PCR is very convenient, cheaper, and popular in most of the laboratories. But at certain times, it faces problem of non-specific amplification, which still produces fluorescent signal due to its double-stranded nature, giving false results. A MELD curve analysis program gives some idea about non-specific amplicons. The second RT-PCR type is a fluorescent probe-based, which produces much more specific and reliable results. This type of RT-PCR variant is most popular for COVID-19 detection. It utilizes Tecman probes containing fluorophore and a quencher molecule in its close proximity. During PCR amplification, Tecman polymerases make new copy of complementary DNA target. As it reaches towards the probe, it cleaves and frees the fluorophore from the quencher with its 5-3' exonuclease activity. During successive PCR cycles, more and more probes releases fluorophore, producing detectable fluorescence signal. Probe-based detection increases the accuracy of detection, Multiple probes labeled with the different fluorophore molecules can be multiplexed together, making it easier to perform multiplex PCR for multiple targets. However, the probe designing makes this technique much more complex. From this point onwards, I will be focusing on the probe-based RT-PCR, which is used for the COVID-19 detection. Now let's talk about the requirements for RT-PCR. The sample of the individual to be tested. As the COVID-19 virus infects the upper respiratory tract of the individuals, most commonly nasopharyngeal or the oropharyngeal swabs are used to perform the test in the COVID-19 suspect. Later on, the RNA is extracted from these samples. The second requirement is the RT-PCR kit. It contains a mixture of components such as the primers and the probes specific for COVID-19 virus, the polymerase, dNTPs, etc. To this mix, the RNA sample is added. Usually, RT-PCR tests are performed in 96 well plates to carry out analysis of multiple samples and save time. A thermocycler. So this is the instrument that performs the PCR by varying the temperature and comes with a computer for the analysis of results. How the primer and the probe are designed. This one is the most important factor that determines the accuracy of the RT-PCR results. Poor designing leads to false results. And if the sample is of COVID-19 suspect, this part cannot be overlooked. The primers are the oligonucleotide sequences of 18 to 24 base pair long. And the probes are usually shorter of 8 to 12 base pair. For COVID-19 detection, two or more primer pairs and probes specific for the COVID-19 nucleocapsid regions are designed using softwares like Primer3. Human RNA-P is also taken as a control to check PCR success. Their melting temperature, self-complementarity, and loop formation ability is appropriately chosen for successful PCR amplification. How RT-PCR actually works? The RNA extracted from the suspected person is added to a PCR tube or 96 well plate containing the RT-PCR master mix. This is then put in a thermocycler wherein a PCR program is set which comprises of denaturation, annealing and extension at appropriate temperatures for amplification of target genes. During denaturation, the double-stranded cDNA is separated, and as the temperature is lowered, primers and probes anneal to the template. When the polymerase starts elongating a new copy of DNA, it encounters the probe and with its 5-3' exonuclease activity, it cleaves the probe, releasing the fluorophore from the close proximity of the quencher and leads to the emission of fluorescence. After successive cycles, more and more fluorophore gets released, which is detected by the instrument in the real-time manner. Now, how to interpret the results? After the amplification is over, the results are shown in the form of CT values or the threshold cycle number. CT reflects the quantity of target mRNA in the sample. Lower the CT value, higher the copy number of the target. Often, CT values are normalized with internal control or the housekeeping gene. To improve the reliability of the results, the tests are performed in replicates and their statistical significance is determined. Based on the standard curves, absolute quantification is also possible. Relative expression among various samples may also be studied. In case of COVID-19, low CT value represents high infection. If CT value is over 35, it means very low or no viral infection is present. Now talking about the advantages and applications of RT-PCR. As the RT-PCR results are available in 2 to 3 hours, hence it is a very rapid method of detection and quantification of gene expression. Fluorescence-based detections makes it a very sensitive technique. TechMan probe-based RT-PCRs are much more reliable and yields reproducible results. Different fluorophore-tagged probes may be designed, hence multiple target genes can be studied simultaneously in a single reaction. RT-PCRs find their application in detection of various diseases. The best example in today's scenario is the COVID-19. RT-PCRs are also used to check the relative expression of target gene in different type of samples, for example, normal versus cancerous cells. Once a standard curve is made, actual quantity of target gene expressed may also be determined. RT-PCRs can easily detect the microbial load in samples such as contaminated water, soil samples, etc. HRM-based SNP detection is also another application of RT-PCR. The details of this can be found in my separate video. Real-time PCRs are also used to confirm the differentially expressed genes or check their expression level, which are identified from the transcriptome or the microarray studies. So that's all for the today's video. Do mention in the comment which part you like the most and what new you learned. And stay connected to my channel for more such videos.